at 9:22. Thanks for being with us on Live at 9. Of course, in our summer heat here in the Mid-South, swimming pools are home to children and adults looking to log plenty of splash time. But where the fun is, there can also be some risks.
A lot of risk indeed. In an effort to stay safe, many Mid-South parents sign their children up for swimming lessons. And CPR expert Barbara Capozella is here with what you need to know before enrolling your kids. Barbara, glad to have you here with us this morning.
Thank you so much. Good morning.
It is that time of year again, and a lot of kids are going to be out and about. You know, parents want their kids to have fun. But what would be the number one tip you want to share with parents out there to prevent drownings?
I think parents need to remember that children are very excited when they get to the pool and they don't read the depth markers and they just go and run and jump. And they may have previously had swim lessons, but that was like a whole year ago. And so the summer starts and they run and they're all excited to participate and jump in, and they don't know how deep the water is. So watch your children. Put your phones away. Don't look at your watches. Watch your children.
So the kids get overwhelmed once they're in the water and then they start to flail, and once they start to do that and panic,
absolutely,
it could be all over.
And that's
second,
an active drowning situation where you want to recognize the child who's lost the ability to reason.
Gotcha.
So you want to just be very aware, even at a facility that has lifeguards at it. Those lifeguards, their attention is divided among many different programs.
Sure.
What about different water levels, though? Because a lot of people will assume, well, if there's not a lot of water in the pool, the kids are going to be okay. What about the different levels we should be aware of when you see a child playing in the water?
You want to be aware that the water can very quickly go from shallow where they can touch to deep. Some of the most dangerous parts of the swimming pool are right along that water depth where the rope is at. And you see little kids who climb across the wall, kind of wall walk, and you'll find that all of a sudden they're in water over their head and they can no longer touch and they let go.
What about things like water wings or the little, I used to have a swimsuit inner tube. But I always wondered if using that was a great relief to me. But I always wondered, I'm not, you know, if they are ever without it.
We want to focus on, if you put a flotation device on your child, that it's a U.S. Coast Guard approved flotation device.
It says that on the tag.
They're designed so that if something happens and your child becomes unconscious, their face is forced upward.
Okay.
If you have some of the inflatables, those can easily slip off or deflate.
Okay, so the
water
arm
wings,
things
we
are
do not recommend.
Safety.
At all. They are not a safety device.
Okay.
So, Barbara, we were showing a few items just a couple minutes ago on the table over there, not too far from us. Let's talk a little bit, though, about CPR itself and its importance these days. Who all needs to learn it?
Everybody needs to learn CPR. There's only about 6% of our population trained in CPR.
Wow.
So that's remarkably low, and it's important that everybody is safe. So get trained in CPR. Put your children in swim lessons. Invest in year-round swim lessons.
Oh.
So they have time to build their endurance over the year and they don't forget all the skills that they learn.
Okay, and at what age? We went through a period where even as young as 6 months, I mean, they would literally to acclimate the child. I mean, what age is ideal?
That's the key word, water acclimation. Start them when they're very young. 3 to 6 months is a great time to get your small children in the water so they learn to hold their breath. So that when we bring them underwater and they come up, they're not coughing, they're not inhaling the water.
Okay.
Then as they get a little bit older, then they're ready to start strokes. But when they're little, have them have the water acclimation.
Okay, so, okay.
How often should one really practice CPR? Because sometimes we think we learn it, whether a child or an adult. Do you need to kind of stay in practice?
Yes, a CPR certification is good for 2 years. I recommend that you do a refresher, and there are many online refresher courses every 6 months, just so you understand the knowledge is power, and practice.
And didn't they change the way we did it, too,
a couple years ago? Every 5 to 7 years, the American Heart and the American Red Cross changes the program.
Okay, so at Lifetime, you have plenty of swim lessons. Do you do CPR lessons as well?
Absolutely, yes.
Oh, okay, cool. One-stop shop.
We have the information right there on the screen for you. Barbara, thank you so much.
Thanks so much.
All right, we appreciate it.